Starship stands as a clear milestone in the field of space exploration. However, its cargo capabilities have the potential to significantly change the military domain. What factors will drive the military intrigue surrounding private spacecraft? In what ways will Starship's functionality change when it is dedicated to military cargo operations? Let's dive deeper into today's episode of NR Studio. When contemplating SpaceX's Starship, one often envisions its significant contribution to space exploration, facilitating human travel to Mars and beyond. However, the United States military has identified an additional prospective application for this innovative vehicle, Terrestrial Transportation Solutions. This concept calls for harnessing Starship's incredible speed and capacity to facilitate extremely rapid transit between distant locations on the planet, a notion that is indeed very logical. Upon closer examination, it becomes clear that Starship is well suited to this mission. The primary attribute that makes Starship so well suited for terrestrial cargo transportation is its unmatched speed. Starship is engineered to reach orbital speeds, utilizing its powerful Raptor engines. In the vacuum of space, without air resistance and atmospheric weather phenomena, Starship can reach speeds that exceed the capabilities of any craft maneuvering in Earth's atmosphere. The procedure is simple and innovative. Starship is set to ascend, reach orbital speed, and then re-enter Earth's atmosphere to land at a remote location. For the military, this capability presents a transformative strategic advantage. It would facilitate the rapid transport of critical cargo, resources, or personnel to any global destination, allowing for rapid response to emergencies or evolving operational demands. To illustrate Starship's incredible speed, one need only look back to Musk's 2017 presentation at the International Astronautical Congress, where he unveiled a video titled Starship Earth to Earth. The video presented a theoretical flight from New York to Shanghai that would take just 36 minutes. In contrast, a commercial airline would take about 12 to 1 hours to complete the same journey. Utilizing Starship technology, the majority of long-haul flights could be accomplished in less than 30 minutes, rendering any destination on Earth accessible within a mere hour. Velocity is not the sole criterion that distinguishes Starship from its competitors. Its payload capacity significantly eclipses that of the most massive cargo aircraft, with a height of 121 meters and a diameter of 9 meters. Starship stands as the most formidable launch vehicle ever constructed. It possesses the capacity to transport 150 metric tons in a fully reusable capacity and can accommodate up to 250 metric tons in an expendable configuration. In comparison, the Boeing 7700, renowned as one of the most prevalent cargo aircraft, possesses the capability to carry a maximum payload of approximately 113 tons. This substantial capacity could facilitate the transport of military equipment, vehicles, and supplies in a single journey. This encompasses formidable weaponry such as heavy artillery tanks and helicopters. Although Starship provides unparalleled velocity and capacity, there exists a significant consideration to bear in mind. Cargo intended for space travel necessitates pressurization to endure the low-pressure conditions prevalent in space. In the absence of adequate pressurization, diminished pressure may lead to the expansion of air. In light of potentially catastrophic failures, such as the rupture of containers or the emergence of biological hazards for the personnel being transported. Fortunately, SpaceX possesses considerable expertise in the management of pressurized environments. Throughout the Polaris Dawn mission, SpaceX showcased its proficiency in sustaining a secure pressurized cabin, thereby safeguarding the astronauts engaged in extravehicular activities. This expertise can be seamlessly integrated into the design of Starship for Earth-to-Earth transportation, safeguarding the integrity of both cargo and crew. The confluence of speed, capacity, and SpaceX engineering prowess in the Starship positions it as a groundbreaking solution for terrestrial logistics. For the United States military, this could signify unparalleled agility in crisis response, operational support, or the deployment of humanitarian assistance. Initially conceived as a vehicle for interplanetary exploration, the multifaceted design of Starship now unveils remarkable prospects for transforming global transportation. Its capability to access any location on the planet in less than an hour has the potential to revolutionize military logistics, as well as commercial shipping and emergency response operations. The future of Earth-to-Earth transportation may indeed hinge upon the elegant, stainless steel framework of Starship. What are your insights regarding this groundbreaking concept? Might Starship evolve into the fundamental pillar of ultra-fast global logistics? We invite you to share your perspective and kindly remember to like and subscribe to remain informed about SpaceX's remarkable advancements. Undoubtedly, Starship's capacity to transport cargo at velocities exceeding tenfold that of commercial aircraft represents a remarkable advancement. However, what about the financial implications? A fundamental design principle of SpaceX is the emphasis on reusability. The Starship is engineered for complete reusability, encompassing both the spacecraft and its super heavy booster. This characteristic renders it especially advantageous for Earth-to-Earth payload transportation, facilitating an increased frequency of flights. The capability of Starship to swiftly return, land, and be refueled paves the way for numerous rapid journeys across international destinations, effectively catering to both cargo and passenger requirements. This reusability markedly lowers travel expenses in comparison to contemporary commercial space vehicles, which frequently necessitate extensive refurbishment or reconstruction following each flight. As infrastructure advances over time, the affordability of Earth-to-Earth transport via Starship may significantly increase. Fuel expenses represent another pivotal consideration. The expense associated with a single Starship launch is approximately $900,000 for fuel, surpassing the cost of jet fuel. Nonetheless, the fundamental rationale behind this is that SpaceX has yet to manufacture its own fuel. To tackle this issue, Musk, in collaboration with another donor, pledged $100 million USD to the XPRIZE competition aimed at fostering groundbreaking advancements in carbon capture and storage, CCS, technologies. Leveraging this technology, SpaceX aspires to synthesize liquid oxygen and methane in-house by sequestering CO2 from the atmosphere. Should this approach prove to be effective, it has the potential to significantly reduce fuel expenditures while simultaneously tackling the environmental issues linked to methane utilization in Starship. For individuals apprehensive about the exorbitant expenses associated with rocket-based goods shipping, there exists an alternative approach tailored for Earth-centric, point-to-point missions that could significantly mitigate costs, employing solely the upper stage of the Starship. In conversations on X, Musk proposed the integration of 2 to 4 Raptor engines into the upper stage of the Starship for these missions, thereby augmenting its single-stage-to-orbit functionality. This adjustment would enhance cost efficiency and streamline operations. It would facilitate long-range missions spanning approximately 10,000 kilometers, achieving speeds of Mach 20, while concurrently preserving a significant payload capacity. Furthermore, the exclusive utilization of the upper stage would markedly diminish noise levels during both takeoff and landing, thereby rendering operations in urban environments, such as major metropolitan areas, considerably more viable. These cost-efficient strategies render Starship significantly more competitive in relation to current rocket models. Although it has yet to achieve full operational status and faces some ambiguities regarding precise costs, SpaceX aspires to lower launch expenditures to between $2 and $3 million per flight. Accomplishing this objective would position Starship as one of the most economically efficient launch vehicles on the market, especially for substantial payloads. Furthermore, the capacity of Starship to surpass other rockets in terms of cost efficiency per kilogram to orbit is quite notable. This vehicle has the potential to revolutionize the possibilities in both space exploration and terrestrial logistics, particularly for high capacity and frequent missions. With its innovative fusion of rapidity, reusability, and economic efficiency, Starship is strategically positioned. Given its groundbreaking capabilities, it is hardly surprising that the United States military harbors significant interest in SpaceX's Starship. The Department of the Air Force is diligently investigating the implementation of rocket cargo transportation for logistics within the Department of Defense. In consonance with advancements in commerce, the Air Force Research Laboratory is scrutinizing emerging rocket technologies from diverse vendors to evaluate their viability for expedited global material transportation. In 2022, the Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, granted SpaceX a 5-year contract valued at $102 million to gather flight data from the Starship aimed at showcasing technologies for point-to-point cargo and humanitarian aid delivery. As stated by the AFRL, the rapidity of logistics is fundamental to achieving military superiority. The organization acknowledges that with a commercial entity such as SpaceX enhancing its capabilities for expedited material transport, the Department of Defense must proactively engage and assess avenues for adoption. This motivation serves as the foundation for the Rocket Cargo Program, an innovative initiative focused on utilizing Starship's distinct capabilities for military logistics. Gary Henry, a senior advisor for National Security Space Solutions at SpaceX, articulated this interest during the 202 Space Mobility Conference held in Orlando, Florida. He exemplified particular scenarios in which the Department of Defense may necessitate the capabilities of Starship. According to Henry, it ultimately hinged on particular missions that entailed distinctly defined and occasionally heightened risks, or potentially perilous scenarios for the Department of Defense. He remarked that the Department of Defense has evaluated whether such missions require the ownership of a comparable asset, or if SpaceX could effectively meet their requirements. The Space Force has been diligently overseeing the advancements of Starship. Notably, General Chance Saltzman, the Chief of Space Operations, was in attendance at Starbase, Texas, to witness the sixth flight of Starship. This indicates a considerable degree of interest and involvement at the leadership echelon. Lieutenant General Philip Garrett, the commander of Space Systems Command, has also expressed insights regarding the potential of Starship. During a discussion with the Defense Writers Group, he noted that we are contemplating potential applications for it. The most rational application, considering the payload capacity, would be a mechanism for the delivery of rocket cargo. He underscored the Space Force's significant interest in the military applications of Starship and their meticulous monitoring of its progress. The capability of Starship to swiftly convey substantial payloads across the globe has the potential to revolutionize military logistics, rendering it an indispensable resource for both strategic maneuvers and humanitarian initiatives. Although Starship exhibits revolutionary potential in payload capacity, reusability, and interplanetary travel, formidable challenges persist before it can be deemed a practical alternative for global high-volume cargo transportation. The primary challenge lies in adhering to regulatory compliance. The Starship is required to comply with both national and international aviation and space regulations established by organizations such as the FAA, ICAO, and various regional authorities. The apprehensions surrounding air traffic management, safety protocols, and adherence to flight regulations are of paramount importance. Additionally, environmental concerns such as carbon emissions, rocket exhaust pollution, noise pollution, and potential damage to the ozone layer will be subject to intense scrutiny from environmental authorities and the general public. Routine and extensive launches will require comprehensive environmental assessments for approval. In addition to regulatory considerations, practical challenges related to Starship's payload capacity pose significant constraints. While capable of carrying substantial payloads, not all types of cargo are compatible with its unique design. Items of such large size or quantity may not be suitable for accommodation in the cargo hold, or may require special handling that is not suited to conditions similar to those in space. Furthermore, Starship's substantial capacity may prove excessive for smaller or lower value shipments, reducing its cost effectiveness in this regard. In fact, developing a truly global cargo delivery network will require significant investment in infrastructure. SpaceX will need to build a global network of spaceports and logistics hubs, an undertaking that will require significant time, investment, and international cooperation. Scaling up these operations while ensuring reliability, efficiency, and safety will introduce additional complexities and associated costs. While Starship has significant potential, overcoming these hurdles will be crucial before it can transform global cargo transportation. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode.